on behalf of the administrative team and all the teachers and staff here at Floyd Central, we want to welcome you to Class Day of 2023. It's been a pleasure to work with your class through all the peaks and valleys of high school. I know that your freshman year did not end the way that we all wanted it to end, and your sophomore year was definitely not a normal year of high school. However, as a group, you guys did an excellent job and persevered. You have much to be proud of and to celebrate. Now, if you're trying to follow in your program, we will go out of order as teachers are available to come in and present their different awards for you this morning. But we have a full agenda, so we'll get started right away. So to make our opening remarks is Vice President of the Student Council, Emma Haley. Welcome.
Hello, I'm Emma Haley, Vice President of the Student Council, and I welcome you to Class Day of 2023. First, a thanks to the Faculty and Guidance Department for coordinating the event. This would not be possible without their efforts. We are here today to celebrate us, the Floyd Central Class of 2023. I believe, however, that we would not be us without all those who have made up the collective them for the past 18 years. By them, I'm referring to the family members who have dedicated their lives to our success, the teachers who have insisted we learn despite our best efforts to challenge those intentions from time to time, and the staff and principals who have created a safe learning environment for us to grow in. Now, I'm pretty sure that I could point to any one of my classmates out there, and that person would be able to tell me the exact number of days left of school. For those of you parents that might be avoiding the thought, I hate to break it to you, but it is 8, including today. Upon further calculation, I found that those 8 days equate to 192 hours, 11,520 minutes, or just over 500,000 seconds. While those numbers make the time seem to stretch even longer, I'd like to put things into perspective. We have raised almost $30,000 at a dance marathon that happened within half a day. We have seen wallflowers transform into dancing machines at a senior dinner dance lasting only 4 hours. And finally, it took our football team less than 2 hours to beat New Albany this season. If all of these lasting memories can occur in less than one of those 8 days, then I challenge you to make at least a couple more before we all walk across that stage. In closing, I would like to thank those of the faculty who are handing out awards today, along with the director of the Horseshoe Foundation, for the presentation of their generous scholarships. Finally, I encourage my fellow classmates to make the most of these celebratory events. Who knows? These next couple of hours might turn out to be the ones to remember. Thank you.
Good morning. I'd like to recognize the 4 following ROTC cadets for outstanding year. Connor Leak, please come forward. Skipping school. Faith Andrews. Carson Bledsoe. Haley Kruer. I'd like to recognize the following students that selected to defend America. The following students have enlisted in the military services. I read your name, please stand up. Please save the applause to the end. Faith Andrus joined the Army National Guard. Andrew Bell joined the United States Army. Eric Connor joined the United States Air Force. Estella Escobar joined the United States Air Force. Celise Hawkinsmith, appointment to West Point. Hunter Hyatt, Army National Guard. Connor Leak, United States Navy. Brad Ryan Madison, Army National Guard. Jack Sanford, United States Naval Academy. Ethan Stoner, United States Marines. And Jacob Wheely, United States Air Force. Please round of applause.
I'm here to present the Social Studies Award for Outstanding Social Studies Students. So will Mia Cochran and Bryce Johnson please come on up here. So I've told a couple people that I was presenting this today, and they asked me, well, how do you guys choose this award? And so our entire department, when we meet on Wednesdays, a couple weeks ago, we put names up on the board, kind of like a mock draft, put these names up on the board. Quite a few of you guys' names out there were mentioned, students who are outstanding in just their effort, their results on their testing, students that we've enjoyed having in class, things like that. Anyway, so we put several names up there. It was more than just two, right? So some of you guys were recognized without being formally recognized up here today. Anyway, and then we narrow these down. So a couple of comments here about Mia specifically. Mia, she has a very positive attitude. She seems to really enjoy social studies. So I hope that that's true. But anyway, that was one thing we observed. And also, she's taken very challenging social studies courses. She's taken 5 AP and 1 IB course in social studies. So very commendable. And then Bryce Johnson, a couple of comments from teachers. Very inquisitive. He asks lots of questions. And that's always a great thing to ask inquiring questions. And he has taken 5 AP social studies courses as well. So they both have taken very challenging course loads as well. They're both very bright. They're well-rounded. They understand history, economics, psychology, government, lots of those things. And they've just been great things. And then one final comment from the department. Both Mia and Bryce exhibit a true love of learning. And the founding fathers believe that our republic would not thrive without an educated and virtuous citizenry, and we believe that both Mia and Bryce exemplify those things that the founders held valuable. So thank you very much.
Good morning. My name is Lauren Baker, and I'm here to present this award on behalf of the Visual Arts Department. We only have one award slot, so this was something that I'd been going back and forth, really making lists, figuring out which way we're going to go. Your all's class has an exceptional group of artists as a whole. If you walk down the hallways now, you can see some beautiful exhibits from our senior artists. So with that said, at the end of the day, did have to make a decision, very pleased with where we landed. Our award recipient has consistently pursued a diversified art educational experience. This year alone, I have this individual for 2 class periods. They're currently in AP Studio Art and in drawing. They've shown involvement outside the classroom, so they're really involved with art club. They're our social media chair, have been for the past 2 years. Dropping some clues, you might be guessing who now. They've been an active member of the National Art Honor Society this school year. Not only are they talented in painting, but also in digital art. They've sought out opportunities for scholarships independent from the school setting and have participated in various local shows. They are willing to share their talents across other departments, including the theater department, where they've created art for posters, t-shirts, stage props, and completed a large panel installation just recently. They are always willing to volunteer, help others out, and they consistently contribute to a positive classroom experience and make for a better overall learning environment for their classmates. This student plans to expand their passion into art as a career and will be studying animation at Lipscomb University in the fall. I'm going to have this person come up now that I did my spiel. They didn't have to stand and listen to me talk about them. Kaylee Johnson, if you would come forward. All right, congrats. It's a joy to get to recognize someone so deserving. Thank you for all your efforts and best of luck. Oh, handshake? No? Okay.
Good morning. My name is Susan Stoy. I'm with the National Society Daughters of the American Revolution. And I'm here to present the Good Citizen Award to a senior class member who has exhibited leadership, tenacity, and service within her community, within him or hers community. Before I announce the winner, I wish to ask that each of you, before the dawn of your 18th birthday, to register to vote. In Indiana, when you're 17, you're eligible to register. And as long as you're 18 years old, 18 on or before election day, you can vote. So you just go to in.gov to begin the process to register. Voting, of course, being a tenet of being a good citizen in this country. I urge each of you to participate in every venue our country offers to its citizens to make a difference. And may I congratulate each of you for achieving this milestone in your lives. The 2023 recipient for the Daughters of the American Revolution Good Citizen Award is presented to Ms. Mia Cochran. Thank you, class.
Good morning. I'm Mr. Hine. I teach biology, zoology, AP environmental science here at Floyd Central High School. In an address to graduating seniors, Warren Buffett, a famous businessman known as the Oracle of Omaha, who notoriously has beat the stock market its long-term average suggested that graduates find themselves surrounded by generous, honest people who have leadership skills in line with the social economy of today. I think that's a great statement. You too will be more likely to have and achieve generosity, honesty, integrity, and become a servant leader. Another thing I would advise is for you to find a job or career you enjoy. We spend many hours at our workplace. If you follow these things, it will likely seem that as you later look back and reflect on your career or your life, that you have actually worked very little and achieved a great deal and helped others succeed as well. A student who has figured this out is Riley Loftus. Please come forward. It may seem weird to say, but Riley really has not worked a single day, as far as I can tell, here at school. I say this because she does for her many life science classes that she has taken and excelled very well in all of those. It seems that she does so effortlessly. That falls under work that she enjoys. When you enjoy something, it doesn't seem like a great deal of work, and Riley exhibits that every day in class. It gives me great pleasure to present Riley with the Science Department Award for Life Science. At this time, I would also like to recognize a physical science student. Please help celebrate the exceptional achievements of a student in the physical sciences. The student who has excelled time and time again, showing curiosity, ingenuity, and perseverance is Lucas Tanner. This remarkable student has exemplified a passion for scientific inquiry, a thirst for knowledge, and enthusiasm to learn throughout many, many high-level physical science courses throughout their academic journey here at Floyd Central. Lucas has consistently demonstrated exceptional aptitude, curiosity, and dedication. Lucas goes even further than that, just being curious himself. He has quietly been helping those around him and be inspired and curious as well. Gives me great pleasure to present the Physical Science Award to Lucas Tanner.
Good morning. I'm Jeff Sequeira. I'm the athletic director here at Floyd Central, and I'm here to present the medals that the students may wear during graduation. They are the IHSA Multi-Sport Student Athletes medals. So we'll just call them up here. We have CJ Sella Husky, volleyball and girls basketball. Emily Cook, volleyball track. Alec Elrod, cross country, swimming and track. Max Granger, football, track. Eli Branham, football, track. Mandy Hess, volleyball, girls basketball. Savannah Little, cross country, swimming and track. Haley Mosier, cross country, track. Hallie. Braden Poe, tennis, track. Jack Sanford, cross country, soccer, swimming, track. Tori Troutman, soccer, track. Nathan Wheatley, cross country, swimming, track. Toria also cheered, by the way. Nathan John Fania, Nate, unified track and field, basketball, and unified football. Asher Gibson, football, swimming. Allie Mann, cross country, track. Ella Nafis, cross country, track. Caden Oliver, soccer, track. Caden Stewart, basketball, track. Joey Jackway, unified track and field, unified football. Maddie Forbus, unified track and field, unified football. Isabel Hullen, unified track and field, unified football. Lauren Bainline, unified track and field, unified football. Reagan Harvey, unified track and field, unified football. And Jacob Titus, unified track and field, unified football. And now we have the multi-sport student athletes with more than 5 varsity letters earned. We have plaques for them. CJ Sella Husky, 5 letters. Braden Poe, 6 varsity letters. Emily Cook, 5 varsity letters. Jack Sanford, 7 varsity letters. Alec Elrod, 5 varsity letters. Tori Troutman, 9 varsity letters. Max Granger, 6 varsity letters. Nathan Wheatley, 7 varsity letters. Mandy Hess, 5 varsity letters. Hallie Mosier, 5 varsity letters. Haley. You messed that up. Sorry about that. And with 11 varsity letters, probably would have been 12, but we had the 1 year that was canceled. Savannah Little, 11 varsity letters. This is also a reminder that I'll be passing out your varsity cords to wear during graduation next week, so please make sure you see me in the spine to get those for graduation. Thanks.
Here to present the English Awards, I'm going to have Ruby Miller and Mia Cochran come on up. Honorable mentions. Ms. Miller and Ms. Cochran were nominated by more English teachers than any other students. And then we'll have the paragon of all English students come on up here. That would be Jack LaFollette. In these current climes, this young man here dauntlessly scaled the menacing Brumous precipice of what is tantamount to Mount Etna. Yes, the advanced placement literature course. It is an epic adventure. It is one that functions as the antithesis to any mock epic of Pope's innovation. And once at the summit, at the culmination of the first semester, he, Mr. LaFollette, adscititiously accepted his destiny as he sternly planted his AP literature flag right there into the ancient formation, earning the top overall grade in this rancorous seminar due to his assiduous study, his unbounded inquiries. Admirably, he maintained that distinction throughout the second semester. As he moiled through the content and the impediments, it was akin to Heracles' 12 labors, yet he added a 13th labor, one stipulated by his teacher, someone of contemporary kin and kith to Heracles' primeval nemesis, Juno. But that did not stop young Mr. LaFollette, for with the intelligence of Dr. Jekyll, and the tenacity of the brackish Mr. Hyde, and with the utmost puissance, he slew each deleterious Stymphalian bird or Numean lion in his path, never succumbing to any of Grendel's devious relations, never abated by the myriad Baroque vicissitudes that would rear their fiendish heads and fangs from day to day, never hindered by an inauspicious albatross. This is Mr. LaFollette, a gentleman worthy of this veneration. And he's more than worthy of this somewhat scant pecuniary award. So congratulations again, Mr. LaFollette, and henceforth, tackle each cleansing of the Augean stables with that same estimable gusto.
How do I follow that? It's ridiculous. I taught English for 30 years and not even I have any idea what he just said, so. But it's all in the performance. I'm Jim Lang. I teach journalism here at Floyd Central, and it's an absolute honor to work with so many outstanding student journalists. I'm just going to ask any senior who is on this year's newspaper staff if you would just stand for just a moment, please, because I can't honor you all. So. Alec, do you have a Purdue shirt on? Yes, sit down. These guys have done a fantastic job, and I appreciate them all, and you have made this a really, really enjoyable and fun senior year, and they've done fantastic work publishing. So take a seat here, because I'm going to honor three of your peers. I wish I could honor them all. These are the kids who have produced the print newspaper, the online newspaper. They've covered social media. They've written about important issues. They've challenged us sometimes on their opinion pages, as good journalists do. And I could not be prouder of them as journalists, writers, and as individual students. So three people that I'm going to honor here today. First is Claire Fermal, our editor-in-chief. Come on down, Claire. I forgot, Claire's got Purdue on too. I'll honor you anyway. There you go. Congratulations. Thank you. And it should be noted here that Claire has actually been editor for 2 years, and that often does not happen. So it really does show what an exceptional leader she's been. And I thank you, Claire. I appreciate everything. Caitlin Winchester, our web director, managing director. Thank you very much. And Sierra Watkins, our photo editor. Every photograph you see on the wall out front, this young lady shot those photographs, and she is an exceptional leader and photographer. Thank you very much, Sierra. You guys have a great day. Thank you.
Good morning, and congratulations to our seniors. For those who don't know me, I'm Samantha Poindexter, and I'm a math teacher at Floyd Central and the student council sponsor. Every year I get to honor those seniors and student council who went above and beyond to represent the student body, boost morale, and achieve our year's goals. Kind of like Mr. Lang, I don't get the honor to celebrate every senior here, so if you were a senior in student council this year, let's go ahead and have you stand up as well. When you research what a student council is, you find several descriptions, but my favorite is that it's a group of student leaders who work with an advisor to collaborate with others to impact their school community, which impacts their city or town, which changes the world. Our student council this year has made an impact throughout the building and community with Spirit Weeks, where they carried anything but a backpack, pep rallies where they played Big Kid Hungry Hungry Hippo, shout out to the seniors for winning, sold crush cans for blessings in a backpack, and collected roughly 2,500 non-perishable items to fill local food pantries through the holiday seasons and beyond. We've accomplished so much this year and even added selling Christmas grams for Angel Tree, an additional Spirit Week, and created our very own Highlander on the Move, which mimics that of Elf on the Shelf. There's no way I would ever imagine doing all of this without the help, guidance, and creativity of the students on Student Council, especially those that held us together like glue, kept us organized and motivated, and showed up every meeting with new ideas and solutions. I thank you from the bottom of my heart, and I wish I had the words to express my appreciation of your hard work and dedication to your studies, extracurriculars, and your peers. Please join me in congratulating this year's Floyd Central Student Council Scholarship recipients, Ella Leitner, Emma Haley, Mia Cochran, and Olivia Eastridge. Thank you all.
Hello. Well, for those who don't know me, my name is Ms. Collins, and I was the National Honor Society sponsor for this school year. We recently held a blood drive not that long ago, and we were very successful. We collected 83 units of blood. Yeah, that's a huge deal. Absolutely. because of that level that we collected, we were able to receive a scholarship from the Red Cross. And when given the task to select a member of our group, a particular student did come to mind for me. She's been consistently volunteering and reaching out. She's volunteered for National Honor Society events, more than one event, and she's gone out of her way to be available and helpful and to lend a helping hand. So it's my pleasure to award this scholarship to Olivia Grady.
Salwete de Skipuli. I'm Magistra Austin, and it's my privilege to hand out several awards today in Latin, English, and speech and debate. Floyd Central has had a great run with speech and debate, even through the pandemic. However, for personal reasons, we were unable to continue with the team. But one student competed during the pandemic virtually and earned the rank of merit. So help me recognize Griffin Miller. Next, I have the honor to award one of the top English students awards to a young woman in my AP Lit class who has great insight and beautiful writing that I'm sure will serve her well in the coming college career. Please help me recognize Emma Haley. Thanks, Finally, I have three Latin students who have earned awards this year. First, I would like to honor a young man who, with determination and skill, achieved the Indiana Bilingual Medal in Latin by achieving an I-5 on the ELIRA exam, Josh Fogel. Next, I would like to honor my two top Latin students for this year. This student has shown excellent in Latin through 3 years of study and has also worked hard to develop skills recently in translating Latin poetry, Olivia Eastridge. And finally, I would like to recognize a young man who's achieved not only the bilingual medal in Latin with an I-5 in his junior year, he also was one of only students to score a perfect score on the National Latin Exam twice. This year he received a gold medal, which made him eligible for the National Latin Exam scholarship. He has shown a love of Latin beginning as a freshman when he read the Iliad in English for fun. He has greatly impressed me with his skill and understanding, and I wish him well in his future, Lucas Tanner.
Good morning. My name is Mr. McRae, and I'm representing the German department. And I have a couple of students this morning that I'd like to recognize for really their outstanding character and integrity. I've gotten to know them for the last 4 years, very trying 4 years, and the last year has been had added difficulties because of scheduling conflicts that have limited the amount of exposure that we've had working with one another. But in spite of that, they've done very well. They've been strong, independent workers, and they're just two very outstanding individuals. And you know, with this being my last year at Floyd Central, I'm very privileged to have known these two young men and to have worked with them, working towards his IB diploma is Carson Stokey. Okay. And thank you. And working towards his Apple test is Bryce Johnson. Thank you.
Dance marathon is a unique beast. It consumes your time, your thoughts, your heart, and sometimes your Instagram feed. But as often is the case, when you give your heart and soul to something that serves to benefit those in need, you get back so much more than you could have ever given away. This group of students poured themselves into our program this year and helped relieve the burden for many families in their time of need. I'm sad to see you go, but I am excited for the compassion that I know that you are bringing out into the world. I am so proud of you. I'd like to honor my senior exec members from Dance Marathon. Avery Bilsland, Anna Curry, Ella Nafis, Emma Fields, Brooklyn Jewell, Emily Cook, Elizabeth Dahoney, Sylvia Sang, Emery Waterbury, Sydney Field, Isabella Mattingly, and Lydia Sprigler. The Spanish department has reviewed candidates and chosen two seniors that have demonstrated enthusiasm and dedication to learning and using Spanish. These two seniors have proven their language skills in class and plan to continue using their language skills in the future. We would like to honor Boston Ross and Paige Lawrence. And every year we give language students the opportunity to demonstrate their proficiency in the language they have chosen to study through a very difficult four-part test that assesses the student's ability to comprehend written and spoken language and produce written and spoken language. Receiving a passing score indicates that these students are indeed fully biliterate. This year for Spanish, we would like to award the Certificate of Multilingual Proficiency to Kaylee Johnson, Boston Ross, Gus Grannon, and Josh Mules. And now we'd like to award the French ones. Okay.
The students receiving the same certificate in French are Eden Rottmeyer and Madeline Langdon. The Language Department has also reviewed applications from several seniors in French and have selected two scholarship recipients. Both of these recipients have shown excellence in their knowledge of the French language and a personal commitment to their self-improvement through linguistic and cultural awareness of the Francophone world. Both of these students have indicated that they will choose to use French to some capacity in their careers, and I know that they will succeed in all of those avenues. Those two students are Madeline Langdon and Morgan Ray.
Good morning. As you can see, and parents out there, you can see our we're dressed in, of course, what the future is going to look like for them. Of course, if people are going to IU, they're wearing an IU shirt. If they're going to work in the workplace, they're going to wear something from that. So, of course, we, the teachers and administration and counselors, are participating in this. It's no lack of respect for our casual dress. We're participating in what we're doing. So, as you can see, this is a lot more laid back than class night, and I think that was a welcome change. I would like to recognize a couple of students here. First, the academic Indiana Academic All-Star. I'd like Harrison Kane to stand, please. You can stay there, Harrison. I don't have your certificate. I just wanted you to stand up. No, you can still stand up. Go ahead. Okay. Harrison was our nominee for the Indiana Academic All-Star, where he made the regional round based on academic achievement. So he was one of 50 students in the state to earn this distinction and was honored at a banquet last month. So congratulations to Harrison. And this next award, this is Radio TV, and I'm going to read this on behalf of Mr. Shaw, who unfortunately got a promotion, essentially. And so I'm going to read what it is that he said about this award winner. Every year I give this award, it gets more and more difficult to decide who deserves it. The truth is, there are so many students that deserve to be honored. Today, however, there is one student who has truly taken the radio and television program to new heights, a person who has excelled at every challenge presented to her through hard work and determination, a person who has not only achieved her goals, but has helped others achieve theirs, a person who has shown kindness, compassion, and tenacity in everything she does. That person is Millie Muner. Millie is one of those rare individuals who can and will do anything she sets her mind to, whether it's pouring hours into a difficult project, winning a sports competition, or directing a live broadcast. She always gives her best and inspires others to do the same. She's not afraid of failure, but sees it as an opportunity to learn and grow. She is not satisfied with mediocrity, but strives for excellence. She is not selfish, but generous and humble. I'm very proud of her and wish her all the best as she continues her storytelling career. Congratulations. And we will see a video that was produced or created by Millie later this morning. And congratulations to her and the rest of the tennis team for winning sectional last night. Boys track did too, and girls track did too, but we'll get to that later. Okay, National Merit. Would like to recognize these students. Would like to recognize those students who perform notably in the PSAT in the National Merit Scholarship Program. There are three types of awards. The first group of students is known as the commended students, whose scores place them in the top 5% of more than 1.6 million students who entered the competition. Would these students stand and be actually come forward, because we have a certificate, so if counselors can help me hand these out. Okay, this is commended, and hold your applause to the end. Natalie Dingman, Joshua Fogel, William Grannon, Grayson Lang, Amelia Muner, and Lucas Tanner. Congratulations. Okay, the next student is considered a National Merit semifinalist by scoring in the top 1% of each state's high school seniors. Please recognize the following students and come forward. Ms. Emma Haley and Harrison Kane. Okay, and in addition, those two students are also National Merit finalists. After becoming a semifinalist, they then entered the competition for being a finalist by meeting additional standards and fulfilling several requirements. Congratulations again to the commended, as well as those finalists, Emma and Harrison.
I have a couple of awards and scholarships to hand out and recognize. The Phi Beta Kappa Association of Kentuckiana honors one senior from each school who has demonstrated the highest level of excellence through rigorous academic coursework, as well as extracurricular activities which exemplify a citizen scholar. The award goes to Elizabeth Kanemitsu. Wendy's High School Heisman Program honors students who are well-rounded young men and women, excelling in learning, performing and leading in the classroom, on the field, and in the community. This year's school winners are Jaden Gomes and Millie Munier. Harvest Homecoming provides a scholarship competition for seniors in the fall. This year's recipients of the Kevin Hammersmith Memorial Scholarship are Micah Yankee and Emma Haley.
Hello, class of 2023. I'm Corey Biebelhauser. I'm a business teacher here at Floyd Central. This year we have a phenomenal lineup of students receiving awards in business and cadet teaching. Every year our business department likes to recognize a student for their outstanding performance in business. We look for students that have a great work ethic and that have taken the time to explore many of our courses offered that are business-minded. Our first recipient this year has spent her high school career successfully completing 9 of our business classes that we offer here at Floyd Central. She has stated that her favorite topics she has studied are accounting and sports marketing, both of which I have had the privilege of educating the student in. This student understands the financial and artistic sides of the business world and plans to expand her knowledge in business at the University of Southern Indiana, where she plans to study business marketing. This student is a very diligent with her work and is eager to learn new things and has even volunteered to find me a job as an accountant if teaching doesn't work out for me. Our award for outstanding business student goes to Kate Satowski. Our second recipient this year has also spent a majority of her time down in the business hallway. As a high school student, she's already a successful entrepreneur and can't wait to study marketing at the University of Louisville. She has a love for sales and marketing and is especially interested in learning how designs and colors affect people. I have had the privilege to work with this student in accounting and business marketing and entrepreneurship. She treated her time that she worked in the Highlander Outfitters store with me like it was a real paying job. She always had new ideas for merchandise and ways that could make the business run a little smoother. She puts 100% into all of her work, shows dedication to her education, and strives to be as successful in all that she does. Our award for Outstanding Business Student goes to Lydia Sprigler.
Hi, my name's Kelly Bratcher. I also work in the business department here and CTE and with the cadet teachers. We have one more business recipient. She has spent time over the last 4 years gaining experience in business, but also in coding and design. She plans to utilize this combination of skills to start her own business when she graduates from the University of Kentucky with a business degree. This student has big dreams and many plans that I fully intend to see her bring to fruition. She's passionate in all that she does and cares deeply for others. Her efforts did not go unnoticed during her time at FC, and I'm confident that they won't go unnoticed in her future either. She plans to take her knowledge and skills and use it for good. One of her goals is to work with a nonprofit outreach project in Guatemala that provides education and nutrition to young girls in need. This student has big goals, but she also has the energy, work ethic, and passion to make it happen. Our final award for Outstanding Business and Technology Student goes to Lauren Bayline. And now for our Cadet Teaching Award. Every year we like to recognize outstanding students for their achievements in cadet teaching. The main goal behind this program is to see if teaching is a career that the students want to pursue. The students get to gain real-world experience working in our elementary and middle schools directly with our students. This year's recipient immediately caught my attention with her passion and enthusiasm for working with children. She brought this energy to the classroom daily and was intentional about building relationships with her students. Our recipient's supervising teacher had this to say about her. My cadet has demonstrated dedication and commitment to the academic and personal growth of young students. I knew she was the perfect fit for my classroom when she walked in on the first day wearing a cute Hello Kindergarten t-shirt. From creating engaging games at home and helping students learn their letters and sounds to designing amazing personalized bulletin boards with pictures of each student, she has gone above and beyond to make her time in the classroom a welcoming and supportive learning environment. In addition to her outstanding classroom management skills, my cadet has also shown great creativity in her approach to teaching. Her ability to plan and implement engaging math lessons for both small groups and the whole class has been truly impressive. She has displayed professionalism in her communication and courteous manner in keeping everyone informed about schedule changes. Lastly, her kindness and generosity towards her students has been wonderful. She has brought Christmas and Valentine gifts for each of her students and included personal handwritten notes for each one. She has even surprised me with caffeinated drinks, showing thoughtfulness and consideration towards others. Everyone that meets her will quickly learn her motto for life, always be a kind human. Our award for outstanding performance as a cadet teacher in kindergarten at Georgetown Elementary School goes to Lily Despain.
Hello. What a great looking group of people. My name is Christy Charbonneau. I am the leader for the peer tutors and the community service leaders, which helps serve students who struggle in school. These leaders in both peer tutoring and also with community service leaders, we had excellent peer tutors and leaders this year. Every single one of them was exceptional. They worried not only about their own grades, but also making sure their mentee was successful and had a successful school year. So we are super impressed with all our peer tutors and community service leaders this year. There were some that stood out that stressed exceptionally well and making sure that everyone was getting what they needed. So the first person I want to honor is Nathan Wheatley. Nathan would come to me multiple times, making sure that he was doing what he needed to do to make sure that his person he was in charge of reached success. And I think it was stressful to him, and he made sure that that everything turned out as positive as possible. The next person is Madeline Smith. Madeline was extremely helpful in Mrs. Preifogel's class and made sure that anything that needed to be done was taken care of. Good. Billy Padgett. Billy made sure that the person she was in charge of felt valued and taken care of and was successful, and he did a great job as well. Addison Bannett. She actually had two periods where she worked really hard and did everything she could to make sure that her students were successful. Savannah Pulliam. Savannah is always super kind, always has a warm smile, always positive, has a great attitude, and is always willing to help. Caitlin Winchester. Same for Caitlin, always a positive attitude, a smile, and willing to help in anything that needs to be done. Thank you. This is for peer tutor for Alice Main. She worked exceptionally hard and took everything to heart. She did a great job. She was extremely helpful with Mrs. Griffin's classroom. Isabella Hullen. We could trust Isabel to take care of anything that needed to be taken care of. She did a great job. She's very compassionate. She's going to be great in what she does in the future as well. Ruby Miller. Ruby is very patient and worked very hard. Thank you, Ruby. And Ella Leitner. We could always trust Ella to do what we needed her to do. So thank you so much, Ella. Again, I want to commend all my peer tutors and all the community service leaders, because without them, our kids could not have been as successful as they were. And we appreciate all the work that you did. You all were fantastic. Thank you so much.
All right, good morning, seniors. I'm Ms. London, and I teach English and advise the yearbook staff. So capturing every single special moment of an entire school year is a really enormous task, and it's something that we don't take lightly. And this year, the seniors receiving an award today have all put in an extraordinary amount of time and effort into making something that we hope you guys will enjoy and look back on for many, many years to come as you go out into whatever this next phase of life is for you. And these students have been really helpful at making sure your senior class is really well represented in the book. So first, I'd like to recognize a few of the staff members who helped bring your senior yearbook to life. First, Chloe Dorinth joined the yearbook staff halfway through this year and has been a huge help at getting more of your seniors recognized in the book, and I honestly can't say it's ever a dull moment when Chloe is around. Senior Sierra Watkins has been an absolute rock star this entire year. Sierra works on both the newspaper and the yearbook staff, and she goes to an insane number of events and works and does so many different things. I don't know how she has time to do anything, and she does such a unique job at, you know, trying to take photos and does senior photos and all kinds of things for many of you in the room. Lastly, Senior Reagan Baker worked on the yearbook staff both last year and then the second half of this year. She's been a very fun presence in our room, and I'm excited to also see you in your freshman year cheering at Ball State, which is my alma mater today. So please give a round of applause for Reagan and Chloe and Sierra to come up. Yes, all three of you have to come up here. Look, and you even said you weren't going to get an award today. All right, hold on. Reagan. Here you go. And Chloe. And Sierra, stay here. All right, ironically though, oh wait, this isn't the end. So the student actually receiving the official award today showed up on my rosters last year with literally no journalism experience at all. She'd never probably touched a camera before, never saw InDesign before, probably wondered every day why she signed up to take this class and had no idea what she was getting into. But honestly, she came in very ready to do whatever I needed for the last 2 years, and even opted to spend an additional period every day working on the yearbook to make sure it's, you know, the best that it could be. She always seems very calm and collected, even when I feel like the room is on fire around me, which is probably true, and they can all say that because we have a deadline on Monday. And honestly, I could not have asked for a better co-editor-in-chief and somebody who's very level-headed to work with for the last 2 years. And for this year's yearbook, the theme is simply just titled Floyd, and it's a magazine-inspired theme that hopefully captures our Floyd family really well and all the things that made your senior year very special and unique. So please give a round of applause for Jaden Peoples.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Hello, I'm Casey LaDuke. I'm an old teacher here and I don't read the memos, so please visualize me in my Ball State shirt, because I don't have my college shirt on. So I teach Project Lead the Way here. Project Lead the Way is an engineering curriculum here at Floyd Central. So I have two certificates of excellence to hand out, along with Tom Hodge and Brick Bannett, the other Project Lead the Way teachers. We always pick two recipients to receive the awards. And this year's awards go to Ben Raymer. Faster, Ben. And the second one is Alice May.
Hi, I'm Teresa Wavell, and I teach the facts classes, and for those of you who don't know, that's Family and Consumer Sciences. I actually am one of the lucky teachers here that get to know their students over long periods of time. I taught English and then six of the facts classes. So the students that I've chosen to honor today are students who have taken almost all, if not all, of those classes and have excelled academically as well as personally. They show great character, leadership skills, and then they're just all around cool people. So today I want to honor Savannah Dupaki. Okay, Then we have Lexi Davenport. And then we have Shauna Baker.
Good morning. Next set of awards are 21st Century Scholar Awards, those who, according to the state, have kept up with their scholar track accounts and are on track to meet the 2.5 GPA requirement for that scholarship. So first we have Isabella Fields. Elizabeth Floyd. Madison Lincoln. Logan Love. Skylar Foxworth. Ariel Shermanitsky. Skylar Stewart. And Todd Ziegler. Thank you.
Okay, the next I'd like to recognize the following seniors that have earned their Eagle Scout, and I did an all call for this a few weeks ago, and so if I missed that or you didn't get a chance to get back to me, please let me know after this ceremony. But I'd like for these individuals to stand to be recognized, and we can hold our applause to the end. Joseph Stivers, Jack Sanford, Josh Fogel, and Ryan Meyer. Congratulations. Eagle Scout. Okay, the next is the Presidential Education Award Program that's administered by the White House and designed to recognize America's most outstanding graduating high school seniors. You have to have a really high GPA for this. And students, it's going to be, there are a lot of you, so we're going to hold our applause to the end or till we have a certain number up here, till we're full, and then we'll let you guys sit down. So I'm going to go through these names. Once again, hold your applause, and we'll get them up here for a brief photo in groups. Samuel Applegate. Hold it. Paige Arrington. Jolie Bain. Addison Bannett. Connor Bassett. You stay up here. Lauren Bayline. Jaden Bowers. Lena Brock. Becca Buckman. Mia Cochran. Justin Cromwell. Abigail Daly. Gavin DeBruner. Natalie Dingman. Elizabeth Dehoney. Chloe Durant. Olivia Eastridge. Alex Elrod. Sydney Field. Josh Fogel. Asher Gibson. Jaden Gomes. Mackenzie Goodman. Olivia Grady. Emma Haley. Spencer Hannigan. Owen Harmon. Abigail Hartz. We'll go ahead and clap for this group. Okay, long enough for a photo. Okay, all right, you guys can sit down. Thank you. And the next group, we have more. Ashley Haste, Olivia Hurdle, Caroline Hilbrick, Alexis Heiner, Silas Hawkinsmith, Reagan Jacoby, Ashlyn Jewell, Bryce Johnson, Kaylee Johnson, Robin Jones, Harrison Kane, Elizabeth Kanemitsu, Anna Kantz, Abigail Kemp, Jack LaFollette, Madeline Langdon, Riley Laritz, Paige Lawrence, Carly Lee, Ella Leitner, Savannah Little, Riley Loftus, Alice Main, Joshua Meals, Amelia Muner, Ruby Miller, Roxy Miller, Isaiah Monroy, and Hallie Mosier. Congratulations. Okay, thank you. Okay, next group, Caitlin Napier, Ella Nafis, Cassidy Nevitt, Keely Page, Logan Piper, Virginia Puckett, Emma Pugh, Lydia Purley, Benjamin Raymer, Boston Ross, Eden Rottmeyer, Kendall Rumpel, Ashley Scott, Patrick Singh, Nathan Shepherd, Abigail Slaughter, Joshua Smith, Kevin Smith, Ariel Smirchinski, Madison Spanopoulos, Lydia Sprigler, Alexandra Stiles, Cora Swearingen, Zoe Tack, Lucas Tanner, Chelsea Tanner, Jeff Wagner, Noah Wathen, Sierra Watkins, Dalton Wisman, Sylvia Zhang. Congratulations. Congratulations. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Briston Hatchell. I'm the assistant band director, jazz band director here at Floyd Central. I have the honor of presenting the outstanding senior performing artist. Every year, the music faculty gets together and we look at all of our seniors and we kind of see who does the most, who has benefited our programs the most. The following student has been a member of not only the orchestra, but also the marching band. So the band program as well as the choir, and is currently in music theory. Our outstanding senior performing artist this year goes to Logan Love.
Actually, would like to make sure that I acknowledge the planning that it took to do something like this. Mrs. Simler planned all of this. It's very difficult to do, to try to get these teachers down here and get covers and all of that. So it might look a little bit organized up here. It's a little hectic and chaotic there, but I want to appreciate and want to thank her for all the work that she has done to get ready for this. Okay, I would like to recognize the class officers, senior class officers, and I deal a lot with especially the executive committee, and I'd like them to come forward and receive a pin for us. The president, and you can hold your applause to the end, there's four of them: President Bryce Johnson, Vice President Mia Cochran, Secretary Addison Bannett, and Treasurer Alec Elrod. Sure. Yeah, I just want to thank them for all of their help, as well as the entire senior exec committee. They reflect, I really think they do a good job of reflecting what type of culture that we have, especially in this senior class, and the attitudes that they have. I bounce some ideas off them, get their feedback, and I think they're very good representatives of everybody up here. So once again, thank you, senior class officers. Okay, the next group will be the National Honor Society. President, once again, hold your applause. President Mia Cochran, Vice President Riley Loftus, Secretary Emma Haley, and Treasurer Lauren Bayline. This group does quite a bit when it comes to, they do the blood drive in the springtime. They did a really cool thing. They gave all the administrators gifts, fed us lunch, made us feel really good for a day. It was really cool. Appreciate that. And they do a lot with, they kind of help organize tutoring. So I want to thank them for their service in making us better as a school. Thank you. And then the last two, I'd like to recognize the President and Vice President of Student Council. President is Ella Leitner, and the Vice President, Emma Haley. Come forward. I've received a lot of compliments when it comes to pep rallies. That's a very difficult thing to do. They put themselves out there, organize something for the entire student body. That takes a lot of forethought. They do a lot when it comes to student morale, things like that. And the next event on that is the Spirit Week next week, which proved to be a little odd, the choice, I got to say. But I think it'll be fun. Looking forward to it. Okay, thank you.
Good morning. My name is Melissa Neal, and I'm the calculus teacher here at Floyd Central. And I've got to say, sometimes, depending on grade level and subject, teaching can be almost like herding cats. But other times, depending on subject and grade level, I just look out at my class in awe and think, wow, these students would be successful even without a teacher. These types of classes are my calculus classes this year, especially Calculus BC. These people are smart, disciplined, talented, intrinsically motivated, logical, and determined to be successful. I am honored to be able to spend time with them every day, even though many days I feel like they don't even need me. They all deserve recognition. But alas, I must choose. This year I've chosen two students who have shown me for three consecutive years that they fully embrace their education. And they love math. Even during COVID and Google Meets, they were math enthusiasts. Even during evening study sessions and bad music, they were math enthusiasts. Even during weekend practice exams, they were math enthusiasts. The math awards this year go to Jack LaFollette and Harrison Kane.
Almost done, folks, I promise. Okay, I would like to recognize and have these students stand. They're listed in your program. We'll get to, I'll have you stand here in a second, but in the second page of your program, it's the Indiana College Corps, the ICC. This is one of the best programs we have going here. This is where students are able to accrue 30 hours of college credit while still in high school and then apply that to any public college or university in the state of Indiana. So essentially they go in, no questions asked, as a sophomore. Now what we're also finding out is that out-of-state schools take those credits as well because they know, number one, those students are going to retain them, and number two, they're going to graduate, and that's what colleges really care about. So I'd like for those students listed, and they will be also noted in the graduation program, those students who have earned the ICC, please stand and be recognized. Okay, thank you, and I can't emphasize how big a deal that is. That's essentially a $30,000 scholarship that all of those students will receive through their efforts in high school. Also, I'd like to recognize those that are earning their associate's degree. There's six of them listed in your program, so if they could stand up just real quick. We have Mia Cochran, Bryce Johnson, Anna Kantz, Logan Piper, Virginia Puckett, and Sylvia Zhang. Those students accrued over 60 hours of college credit. Congratulations again. The last award that we give is for a staff member. And in a school this size, we have a lot of fantastic teachers, and it's hard sometimes to get show your appreciation for all of the great teachers that we have. In a school the size, the principal is always looking for staff members who are willing to go the extra mile and open up opportunities for students. This particular teacher does a lot that goes unnoticed to the general public and the student population. During this teacher's long career here at FC, she has shown herself to be a tireless worker and a lead instructor. This person works well past the teacher workday, as well as on weekends, early mornings, and into the evening, whether it be preparing lesson plans, covering for a colleague, helping fellow teacher to improve their instruction, preparing her department for collaboration, or covering for radio and TV. She's a teacher leader as well. When we have new teachers in the building, I want them to see her and how she interacts with students and how she runs her classroom. There have been times, lots of times, that I've sought her out for advice, for she has always been honest and thoughtful with me. She is the type of teacher that we all want to have and want our children to have. So, for those reasons, and for service to FC and inspiration to the students of Floyd Central, I would like to recognize the Tribute of Excellence recipient, Mrs. Rebecca Cambron. Yes. Okay, she does get to speak, but a reminder that I get the microphone last. We had to tell her that she had to come down here because I needed to see her because we had a math teacher hire for next year that backed out. So that was a pretty good excuse, right?
Well, I fell for it, and then as I was walking down here and I came in, I was like, that was the dumbest excuse I've ever heard. But I did fall for it momentarily till I walked in. He's not wrong. I've been here a long time. I was here as a student many years ago. I won't tell when. Then I've been here 22 years. Great experience. Came back. My kids came through. Couldn't have a better place to have graduated from and to watch everybody that I've seen through the years graduate. It's a great place to work. We have great students. We have great parents, great administration, great counselors, great support. I couldn't do anything I do without you all and without them. So thank you very much.
Yes, we did pass these hallways together, Mrs. Cameron and I. We'll just say that she is older than I am. Okay, so what we're going to do now, we've been here for just 1 year, but it's still, okay, and you always will be. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to take about a 10-minute break because what we need to do, number one, you've been here for a long, long time, and we're going to get set up. We have the Jumbotron is not working well, so we are going to set up a screen here to watch the year in review. So you guys can take a stretch break, go to the restroom, do what you have to do, and then we'll get back in about 10 minutes.
Summer went away, still the yearning stays. I play it cool with the best of them. I wait patiently, he's gonna notice me. It's okay, we're the best of friends. Anyway, I hear it in your voice. You're smoking with your boys. I touch my phone as it fits your face.
I'm gonna run into the fence.
I dream of getting out. There's just one who could make me stay all my days.
And the 2023 State Champion Orchestra flag is awarded to Floyd Central.
Just to see you live. Search the party of better bodies just to learn that you never cared. You're on your own, kid. You always have been.
This time, please help us congratulate our homecoming queen and king, Sophia Wood and Nate John Fania.
Make the friendship race, let's take the moment and taste it. You got no reason to be afraid. You're on your own, kid. Yeah, you can face this. You're on your own, kid. You always have.
When you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hoping the water rises, you build a wall. Hoping the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad.
Thank you. Thank you, Millie, for doing that. We're going to go ahead and I'm going to remind you guys that this link will be available. We'll get that out to you guys soon, make it available to everybody. This will also be rebroadcast. You'll have a link to this whole ceremony on WNAS soon. We got prom tomorrow. Okay, awesome. And as evidence, guys, we've had a great year. Let's finish it strong. I'd like you guys to be back to class to touch base with your third period teacher by 10:05, please. 10:05, that gives you some time to mingle with your parents, take a Polaroid, and enjoy the day.